Today we are going to see about company accounts. In company accounts, we are going to see about the forfeiture of shares. So what is this forfeiture of shares is? When a shareholder defaults in making his payment against the allotment of calls, his shares are forfeited. That is, his shares are cancelled. So when you cancel a share for the organization, it will result in the reduction of the share capital. So how we are going to reflect this cancellation of shares, that is forfeiture of shares, into the journal entries is share capital account data to share allotment to share call account to shares forfeited account. So you can either write it as to forfeited shares account or to shares forfeited account. However you write, it's correct. And the calculation part will be for the share capital, you're going to write the full called up. For the allotment, how much is unpaid, amount unpaid is going to be calculated. For share call, again, how much is unpaid amount. Then for share forfeiture, so far how much that particular person shareholder has paid is going to be calculated. So your narration is going to be shares forfeited for non-payment of allotment and call money. So this is the forfeiture sum. So let me read through the sum so that you know what is happening. So Arjun was holding 1000 shares. So Arjun is a shareholder. He is holding 1000 shares at rupees 10 each. So the face value is going to be rupees 10 of Varnaville Electronics Limited, which is not necessary for the sum, issued at par. He paid rupees 3 on application. So what all he has paid is, he has paid 3 on application and 4 on allotment. That is paid. What he did not pay, that is he could not pay the first and final call of rupees 3. The directors forfeited the shares for the non-payment of call money. Give journal entries for the forfeiture of shares. So since he did not pay this call money, for his 1000 shares, his shares are going to be forfeited. So we must give the journal entries for these. So this is the journal entry for which Arjun was forfeited. So share capital account data to share first and final call to share forfeiture. When you compare it with the normal journal entry, we had share allotment also. But here he has paid the share allotment. So that is not taken into consideration. What he did not pay the first and final call. So only first and final call will be taken up for forfeiture. So now let's get into the calculation. So share capital. So how much of shares we are dealing with? 1000 shares. So 1000 into the called up value is rupees 10. So 1000 into 10. Next, if you go, it is to share first and final call. So how much is first and final call? Rupees 3. So 1000 into 3 unpaid. Then two shares forfeited. So if you see, this is a debit and this is a credit. So 10 minus 3 will give me 7. That is 1000 into 7. So far he has paid. So if you add this to 3 plus 4, 7 is paid. So far he has paid 7 rupees. Right? So 1000 into 10, I will get 10,000. And the other two credits are 3000 and 7000. So when I add up 3000 and 7000, I will ultimately get 10,000. So this is a very, very simple sum which shows the forfeiture of shares. Forfeiture sum number 9. Lakshit was holding 50 shares. So Lakshit is a shareholder who is holding 50 shares at rupees 10 each. He paid rupees 2 on application. So he has paid rupees 2 on application but could not pay 4 on allotment and 2 on first call. So he did not pay allotment money and the call money. Directors forfeited the shares after the first call. So after the first call, they forfeited his shares. That is, they cancelled his shares. Give journal entries for recording the forfeiture of shares. So since allotment and first call is forfeited, so in my journal entries also I must write allotment and first call. So let's see the journal entry. So the journal entry is share capital account data to share allotment account to share first call to shares forfeited, because allotment and call money is not paid by the shareholder. So how much of shares are dealt with here is 50 shares into. Now if you take this sum, add it up and see 2 he has paid and he did not pay 4 plus 2 is 6. 6 plus 2, 8 rupees only is being in the scene. It is not the entire 10 rupees. And the director immediately after the first call itself, they didn't go in for the final call. They have cancelled the shares. Therefore, it's only going to be 8 rupees here. So 50 into 8 is going to be 400. Next, share allotment. So how much of share allotment money he did not pay? 4 rupees. So 50 into 4, that's going to be 200. Next, share first call. So 2 rupees of share first call. So 50 into 2 is 100. So 200 plus 100 is 300. So I need another 100 rupees over here to get the 400 debit. So 50 into 2. Or if you do it this way, 4 plus 2 is 6. 6 minus 8 is 2. So I'll get another 100 here. So 200 plus 100 plus 100 will become my debit. That is my 400. My debit is equals to credit.